you've ever tried to understand chaos theory, you're probably more confused by the explanations than you are by the theory. Something about weather and clouds and trees and butterflies and... The trick to understand chaos theory is simple. It isn't one theory. It's many. Each piece is its own thing. For example, the stuff about clouds and trees and oil drilling, that's called fractals. It's fascinating in itself, but it's not what I'm going to cover today. Today we're going to talk about predictability, or the lack thereof. Hold on, this isn't as boring as it sounds. Remember Happy Gilmore? What if, instead of a hockey stick, Adam Sandler tried to hit a golf ball with a baseball bat? And now suppose it's not a very good baseball bat. It's all rough and bumpy and beat up. Try hitting that straight. And why can't you? Because there is a lack of predictability. No matter how closely you examine the bat, you can't tell for sure where it will hit and what will happen. Now here's the tricky part. If you could build a machine that was precise enough and had it swing the bat, it would be able to hit the ball exactly the same place over and over again. It just has to be more precise than the bat is bumpy. This is the nature of chaos theory and predictability. When something is sufficiently bumpy, we can never get precise enough to predict the outcome. Well, you say, why do we care? Baseball bats and golf balls are machined to be smooth, so it's not a problem. Well, sure, but chaos theory isn't about sports, it's about nature. And nature is bumpy. Take a close look at a tree bark sometime. This extends to all kinds of natural phenomena, including weather and stock markets. There's an old adage about this. In other words, the tiniest little thing at a crucial time or place can make all the difference. If you don't believe me, consider what might have happened if a few more voting machines in Florida in the year 2000 had been properly maintained so there were no hanging chads. Aha! Now you know what I'm talking about, don't you, Mr. Gore? So, if something so small can affect something so big, does that mean everything we do has enormous consequences? Of course not. It's just that there's really no way to tell which ones will and which ones won't. Which is why it just might make a difference if you turn off that light switch. Or maybe not.